I am the Reverend Kevin Mekalani, priest for the Church of the Ascension in Mona Heights. And I have the privilege and pleasure to serve with great humility as chair of the Hope Area Churches Organization, which is a gathering of Christians of many denominations, comprising 10 congregations who have been working together for the past 50 years. It has been a wonderful fellowship that we have shared through good times and bad times. At a recent executive meeting of HACO, we took the decision that this provides us with a wonderful opportunity to engage each other in a theological God-taught understanding of disasters, which have been part and parcel of human life, part and parcel of the Jewish Christian heritage of which we're all a part of. We felt it was a wonderful time for us to engage and learn about the faithfulness of God and how, in spite of all of these things, there is hope. So, I begin a series on behalf of my brothers and sisters that will engage us across various social media platforms as we share with one another for the hope of God in these challenging times. Let me begin as a prayer by using two verses of a hymn from our hymnal. We pray. Father, I place into your hands the things that I can't do. Father, I place into your hands the times that I've been through. Father, I place into your hands the way that I should go. For I know I always can trust you. Father, I place into your hands my friends and family. Father, I place into your hands the things that trouble me. Father, I place into your hands the person that love me. For I know I always can trust you. Amen. The passage that I want to use for our reflection is Matthew 24. And I begin at verse 6 through to 8. Jesus says, "You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you're not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places." The word of the Lord. In what is a troubling message to his disciples, Jesus makes it clear that life as we experience it on earth is not always going to be smooth, tranquil, still. Sometimes we have to live through moments of upheaval that will severely test us. In that same conversation that he's having with his disciples, he paints also a very grim picture about the status of interpersonal relationships. This is what he has to say. At that time, many would turn away from the faith and would betray and hate each other. Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. But he who stands firm to the end will be saved. And that is from Matthew 24, verses 10, 12, and 13. Yes, from what we've heard, Jesus paints a grim picture. But he does end on a note of hope, victory, and salvation. And that victory is reserved for those who stand firm to the end. This begs the question, on what shall we stand? What is the faith to which Jesus referred earlier in the passage? Without going through the rigors of biblical scholarship, I would take an educated guess and say it refers to the faithfulness of God to his creation, that desires that all should experience the kingdom of God or the kingdom of heaven, as it is referred to in Matthew's gospel. Incidentally, the very first sermon of Jesus was recorded in the Gospel according to Matthew. Begins with an invitation to find blessedness and joy. In what has become known as the Beatitudes, those first 12 verses of Matthew 5, Jesus lists some characteristics which by the standards of the day would not be popular or considered the criteria for happiness. Yet, those are what he described, prescribed as the medicine to find salvation. In this world of dis-ease. This begs again another question. Do we trust that the diagnosis and medicine that Jesus prescribes will give rise to true salvation? That is a question that each of us has to answer for him or herself. Interestingly, however, at the end of that sermon, Jesus makes a comment on what he has diagnosed and prescribed for all welfare and salvation. And of course, the sermon I'm referring to is the Sermon on the Mount. He says in Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 27, "Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall, because it had a foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash." Yes, brothers and sisters, Jesus is very, very clear. He believes in what he offers to the world as salvation and invites us to do the same. Therefore, living by the fruit of the Spirit, which is described in Galatians 5, 22, 23, even in these troubled times, is worth it. Worth it because of John 3, 16, which I invite us to say together. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." So, the gospel, as Jesus says in Matthew 24, verse 40, will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come. I think we'll find that to be true, even in the midst of this COVID-19 pandemic. The gospel will come alive, because this is the way that we are going to be able to cope, thrive, be victorious in these times of isolation by building communities in Christ and by the ourselves. So, brothers and sisters of Paco, keep the faith, be safe, build a community, and speak peace and goodwill to all. Let us pray. God of goodness and love, in whom we can trust in every hour of need, have mercy on all who are faced with fear and distress in this pandemic. We ask that help be given to them speedily, and that this emergency may be turned into an opportunity to strengthen the bonds of love and service which bind humanity and nations together. We pray especially for our healthcare professionals and all other persons who work on the front line of this pandemic, for our security forces who must keep law and order, for government officials and leaders who must make policy decisions, for teachers and students who must carry on the business of learning. And let us remember especially our brothers and sisters who have died. May night perpetual shine on them, and may their souls and the souls of their departed rest in peace. God bless you, my brothers and sisters.